As I said in my workshop, usually there's a tension, a built-in tension between in the relationship between scientists and journalists. Scientists are always suspicious of journalists, and they think that we want to take their research and do do something totally different out of it just to make it clickbait or viral, and it's not true. And journalists are always suspicious of scientists that they work so slow and they have to check everything and they don't understand anything in journalism. They just want their facts right, but they don't understand how to draw in readers. So we need to understand each other more, and we need to build this trust, and they need to understand that we work on a different time scale. We have a super stressed deadline, they have, you know, a very long time to work. There are many other differences, of course, the way we work, the methods, the who we work for. Journalists work for readers, so we wanted to appeal for readers, and scientists not necessarily so. But once we learn the disabilities, the abilities, the good, the flaws, the positive things about each other and how we can work together, it could be amazing, especially for the public, because we can really bring science into the public, and it's super important in so many ways, and it's even more important today when we have such threats on science, on facts, and on journalism. I thought they are very into the whole workshop. I was very much surprised at how active they were and how enthusiastic they were. It was super interesting to hear their answers and to be engaged with them. It wasn't a lecture, a full frontal lecture. It was a workshop, and I enjoyed their remarks. It was super intelligent, and I learned a lot. As they learned from me, I learned from them. So you chose very well the people. And it was a good mixture of scientists, journalists, and also science communicators, which is a whole new species of scientists, I guess, that are more keen into making science popular science. And it's super important because they are the facilitators. They are the buffer zone in between the science world and journalists or the public, and they're super important, and I was very happy to see that they're all here and how much passion they have about presenting science to the public in a simple and but factual and true way. Yeah, so what is unique about Israel is that we are very advanced in science, and we have many scientists, and many people understand the scientific language. And even though Hebrew is such a strange language, everybody speaks English, so they are very well, you know, they know what's happening in the scientific world. We have this, you know, high-tech nation. But on the other hand, we're not very open to popular science. It's not a field that is very much developed in Israel. In the United States, for example, from really young age, they learn how to read science. They do those science posters in the classroom. They learn like the scientific world and jargon. And in Israel, they don't. So you're either in the scientific community or you're not. But lately, thanks to many scientists, some of them were here, thanks to many newspapers, the popular science is rising, and more people learn how to read scientific research and articles about science, and to realize how important it is and how it relates to their own life. So we are on the rise, and there is still a lot of potential, which is very exciting for me because I can still, you know, grow and grow and grow as a science correspondent in a way. And also editors are learning that these stories could be viral and they catch readers, so they are keen more on publishing them. So I think we still have a long way to go, but we are definitely in the right direction.